was always asked when I'd pack it in, you know, when I'd stop gymnastics. And my answer, it was always, I will continue to do this sport until I fall out of love with it, or my body doesn't allow me to do it anymore.
Now Wilson has had to pull out of the all-round
Olympic bronze medalist. Now Wilson with the European Championships after having ankle surgery.
2 days before flying to Doha for the World Championships, Niall Wilson has had to pull out after snapping two fingers in training.
Wilson suffered a career-threatening neck injury. He's undergone surgery but is likely to be out of action for much of the year and faces a battle to get back in time for next year's Olympic Games in Tokyo.
Well, another high-flying Yorkshire youngster is hoping for great things in the world of gymnastics.
Yes.
He's good.
Niall was hugely competitive, energetic, and I do want to say he's very impressionable. You know, what you asked him to do, he would do. You wanted him to climb a rope, wanted him to do a million routines, you know, he was really wanted to please you.
Niall made history at the Junior Europeans, earning 5 gold medals. That record still stands today. This is a
wild game of survival. Good dismount to come.
Come on, boy. Hanging in a double-double and the tiniest of adjustments. What a performance.
He's got back to his medals, I'll tell you that.
Every move was never
in doubt. He's got a clear vision, a clear goal. He's really developed into a very strong-minded individual. Quite a very small minority of incredible human beings who is that professional, that competitive, and is actually thrive under that pressure.
I'm gonna cry. little boy. Taking it to gymnastics every night. He loved it.
Niall's career was just a pleasure to be a part of.
The journey that Niall was on was an amazing journey. And we as a family, particularly me, just felt so privileged to be a part of the journey that he was on.
Niall, first and foremost, will always be my favourite all-round gymnast. And there's no one better to step onto a competition floor with. You know, for me, on a competition floor, I'm hugely anxious. But when you've got an individual like Niall saying to you, as you walk up on the podium or you're about to lift him on the ring, saying, hey, check this out, watch this. I'm going to smash this routine. Sucked up the floor and landed and punched the air and just was totally thrilled. It's just been an absolute pleasure to even be a small part of that feeling. I'm done. I said two statements at the start of the video, and it was about falling out of love with the process of doing it, and it was about whether my body wouldn't allow me to do it anymore. And to be honest, sat here today, I feel like both of those things are true. They kind of go hand in hand for me. The amount of pain, you know, that I felt this sport in the last 2 years has caused me, you end up falling out of love with the process no matter how much you give. My body just sent my bike back, and it's been one of the toughest decisions of my entire life, because it is my life. You, as an athlete, your identity is your sport, what you do. Since 4 years old, I get up every day and I do gymnastics. That's my only purpose. I'm proud of my career, what I've achieved. I'm more so proud of how I've brought the sport to light, to the world, revolutionized it. Being a champion, being a real champion, it's not about medals, it's not about being in the gym, it's not about being a Commonwealth world champion.
being a real champion comes from within. It's about you, what you achieve on a personal level. And what Niall's achieved out of the gym, in my opinion, far outweighs anything he did in the gym, because he's an amazing person and has overcome many amazing obstacles that are not about winning gymnastics and medals.
A lot of people know me pretty well as Niall Wilson's sister, and that's a really cool thing to be, but it wasn't the gymnastics or the medals or the whatever, it's just Niall is pretty awesome.
My proudest moment, they've not been seen, they've not been publicised, because where I felt the most, I feel like I'm getting emotional actually, where I felt the most pride is the stuff that I've come through. The neck, the pain, the mental health. I'm more proud on the days where I've 5 months from neck surgery, I've got metal in my spine. I've stepped in a gymnastics club and I've done world-class gymnastics when doctors and people told me I won't be able to do it. And no one saw it, but I'm more proud of that than any medal. Pride for me comes from what I've overcome, what I've learned, the person that I've grown into.
Sadly, Niall is broken through injury, and it's the right time.
I think the initial reaction, everyone I'm sure listening will think, is sad. And it's not sad, it's not like the end of Niall. Niall will always be a gymnast. What he's achieved is his legacy. So I'm not sad, I'm just immensely proud. I wanted to change the game and I feel like I've succeeded in that. And I want to say that although it's the end of an era, Niall Wilson has retired from competitive gymnastics. I don't need to find a new identity. I will always be Niall Wilson, the gymnast. You just won't see me on the telly at the Olympics.
The last time any of us saw him compete was at the Gold Coast Commonwealth Games, where he absolutely dominated. And if someone would have told us during that competition that that would be the last time we ever saw him compete, I think firstly we wouldn't have believed them, but secondly we'd have soaked it in a little bit more.
Thank you so much for everyone that's been on this journey. My family, my coaches, my physios, the medical team, and then, you know, maybe more so importantly, the teammates that were stood beside me the whole time. The ones on the battlefield, on the competition floor, I've just had an absolute blast. I just want to thank every single person that's supported in whatever way in my gymnastics career, that's watched me, that's found inspiration from the things that I do. And I was just a young boy with a dream, with a desire, with fire in my belly, with a work ethic bigger than anyone else's. And I'm living proof that you can do and achieve whatever you want in this life.
I just wanted to see him compete one more time, just one more time. And with the news that's been announced, maybe that's now not possible.
The thing that's made this decision a lot easier for me, someone said to me, you do know Niall, you can change your mind. The big decision like this is actually that difficult. Either way, whatever you decide, it's going to be fantastic. You're going to be awesome. And also, whatever route you go down, you do realise the door never closes. And will I compete again? Right now, I'm going down that road, but who knows what the future holds for now. So.
Recycle your pain. Get something from it. You already in pain. Use it. Do something with it. Allow it to take you to the next level. Allow your pain to push you to greatness. Get up. Get up. Sometimes in life, you have to hit back. Everybody's trying to stop you. Everybody's trying to kill your dream. You're going to prove all of them wrong.
I don't care what the scoreboard says. We're going to be winners.
So now you got to go out and show them that I'm a different creature. Now! Than I was 5 minutes ago.
This is your time. Now go out there and take it.
You know what you're worth, now go out and get what you're worth.
Again and again and again, the lights are cut off, but you're still looking at your dream, reviewing it every day, and say to yourself, it's not over until I win.
Make a declaration to yourself. I'm unstoppable. This will not get me down.
Live your life now. Live your dreams